Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to do environment setup for our React application. So environment setup is nothing much, it's just about installation of Node.js. React.js is just an npm module which we just need to install and we can get started with React. Okay, so what primary thing which you need to get started with React.js is the basic intermediate level of knowledge of JavaScript, and second thing is you just need to have a Node.js installed on your system. Okay, so for Node.js what you can do is you can just install Node.js directly, from the Node.js website. I will suggest that you should install Node version manager instead of installing that exe or the Node.js package, node package from the website. You just install the Node version manager. What it will do is you will be able to switch to different versions through Node version manager. Okay, you will be able to switch to 12 version, 8 version, 10 versions based on your comfort. Okay, so I will suggest you just run this particular command on your terminal. If you are running on Mac and Ubuntu, you can just run this and then you can install the latest version. You just need to do nvm install node. Okay, I will not suggest you to do the actual development on the Windows and other systems. For developers, like, you should always use either Ubuntu or some Linux system or Mac, because using Windows is fine, but there are always a lot of troubles with these packages which are compatible, right? But when you use these Mac and Linux distributions, your things will be easy. I mean, you will see the real difference of the development on Mac or Ubuntu instead of doing it on the Windows. Okay, so once you have the Node.js installed on your system, we can just go ahead. And now next thing what we can do is, once you have the Node.js installed, which I will show you how to do it, okay, then we'll start thinking about what is React.js. okay, we already know that React.js is a JavaScript framework. Okay, what it is doing is it is helping us to write front-end application, front-end components. Through these front-end components, we are able to build the UI. Now that UI can be your blog application, your Facebook, your Instagram app, or using React Native, you will be building any of different kind of application, right? So what basically React is a JavaScript framework. At the client side, it is helping you to build the UI applications. Okay, it is running on the browser. Okay, and we have a different versions of React, React 15 and React 16.x is the latest one we will be using. And with React is, we will be writing JavaScript, right? And with JavaScript, we will be using the ES6 syntax. So we earlier, 2 years back, we were writing the React component with the ES5, which is earlier version of JavaScript. Now we are using ES6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These will be the versions will be coming in JavaScript. And React is just providing that compatibility with the help of Babel. Babel is a third-party module which is making your React code compatible with different JavaScript environments. Okay. Now, first thing is, React is a JavaScript framework. We got it. React is helping us to build the UI. But now, how React is different from other framework, like we have Angular, Ember, Vue.js, right? And many more. I will name it. So there are many front-end framework we already have. React is keeping it aside, right? It is on the edge and it is more popular than any of these framework because it is providing a lot of optimization when the component is rendering. Any change you are making in the component, it is just updating the UI just in the flicker. 60 frames per second is the speed of React component render. Okay, so we will talk about the comparison in one of the separate video, but we will start with what is React. React is a JavaScript framework which is providing us a way to write UI components. Now that UI component can be text field, your HTML form, your header, your footer, your data table, your data grid, your accordions or your new bar, all these things we are doing with the React. Okay, so first thing is environment setup and all. So what we are doing is we install Node.js. That is enough for the environment setup. NPM is coming with the Node.js. And I'm considering that you already know something about JavaScript like ES6 and all. Then we will talk about what React.js component look like, the hello world of React.js component. I can show you the code, but that will be appropriate if we come to that later. Okay. Now, what React? React is a component-based development approach. Earlier, if you talk about the earlier web development we were doing, is we were using some kind of like jQuery we were using, and we were writing our pages with the jQuery. We were doing DOM manipulation, we were writing the forms, we were making the XHR call, AJAX call to the APIs, getting data based on the button click, based on the user action on the UI, we were changing things. So what has changed now in the React and jQuery? The main difference here is about DOM manipulation. jQuery also was doing the same thing which React is doing, but React is doing that in the far better way. jQuery was traversing the whole DOM to change something on the UI. Consider you have a shopping cart application. You click on some button, something happens. You click on checkout button, it will take you to the payment page. A lot of things are happening in the interactions, right? So what is actually changing on the whole page? The DOM layout, the elements in the DOM are getting changed. So what is changed with React? That DOM manipulation is very much optimized with the help of React. You don't need to traverse the whole DOM to change something. You click on text field, you click on button, you are submitting the form, you are clicking on some button, something is happening. So some visible change you see on the UI, that is DOM manipulation. And React is doing that far better than any other framework right now. Okay. Coming back to this, we have done the basic installation of Node. What you need is you just need a VS Code and Node.js installed on your system. After that, our development environment is ready. Now we just need to understand how React works, how to compile React component, how the React component rendered on the browser, and how to write the Hello World component. Okay. So I will just directly jump there. I will not take a deep down example. So first of all, we understood that React is a framework, right? But it is a very lightweight. It is, if you compare React with any other framework, which are very heavyweight, but the learning curve for React is very small. It is just merely a small components you can write, right? Even small application you can build in less number of lines of code if you compare with any other framework, right? Okay, so React is helping us to build UI. And what UI contains? Some kind of a header, footer, body, some grid, some data table, right? So what React will be helping us to build these data tables, header, footer as an independent component, right? You will hear this component word throughout my series because we will be building component everywhere. Your UI of your application will be combinations of all these different components. Okay, header will be a different component, navbar, sidebar, footer, body, everything will be an independent component we have on the React. Okay, simple. I'm printing hello world, this is also a component. Okay, and then I'm rendering this component on some DOM node. Right, so React is helping us to build the component, and then next phase is show that component on UI. This is how I build something in the React, and now here I am mounting that component on the DOM. It is just a simple function, right? It can be a simple class also. Class hello, sorry. It just need to extend the React.component, otherwise it will be just a simple class. Now this also become a component. Now you will be writing a render function inside it, and that render function will return something to be shown on the UI, right? So hello is some UI component which is returning me the hello message. I need to show this on the UI, so I will be doing this phase 2 task where I'm rendering this component on some UI element. Okay, coming back to our slides. So in the next video we'll talk more about this Hello World React component. Before that, we will verify the Node.js installation. Okay.